This is a bit of biology with Mr. Rock, and today we're going to be talking about trophic levels and the 10% rule. Before I can begin to describe what trophic levels are, I need you to understand that there are two different groups of organisms in ecology, and we differentiate them by how they get their energy. So the first group is called producers. Producers are also known as autotrophs, and these are organisms that get their energy from doing photosynthesis by taking sunlight energy and converting it into food. So these are usually plants. The other group, and this is most often what you think of when you think of like a living organism in biology, we call these consumers, also known as heterotrophs, and they get their energy by consuming other organisms. So they need to eat other organisms in order to obtain their energy. An example of these would be animals. So the categories for consumers break down a little more into specifically what type of food they are eating. So you may have seen some of these words before, but I just want to go over all of them. First, we have herbivores, and they only eat plants. Carnivores only eat animals. And omnivores eat both plants and animals. The two you might not have heard of before are detritivores and decomposers. Detritivores are also known as scavengers, and they usually eat dead plants or animals like roadkill. So you could think of something like a vulture as a detritivore. And decomposers are going to be things that eat dead organic matter. And an example of that would be an earthworm eating dirt. Okay, so now that we understand that there's different kinds of feeding within an ecosystem, I'm going to explain what a trophic level is. And it really is just a level of feeding within a food chain. So with that, we're going to describe some terms that describe how an ecosystem is organized. So here we have a food pyramid, and what you're going to see is the bottom of the food pyramid is made up of primary producers. So the bottom, the foundation of a food pyramid, is made up of plants. And next, we go up to the primary consumers. So those would be things that only eat plants, like herbivores. And the secondary consumers eat the primary consumers. The tertiary eat the secondary. And the quaternary eat the tertiary. So to give, I guess, a better image of this, I want to show you this image because I think seeing animals assigned to these categories is a little more helpful. So the first level of the trophic level is the primary producers. And you see that on the bottom, and those are plants. Those are the producers. So that's primary producer. That's the first level. The second level of a food chain or a food pyramid is called primary consumers. And these are herbivores because they only eat plants. So this would be an example of something like a cricket. Secondary consumers are the third level of the food chain. And they eat primary consumers. So that would be like a mouse. Tertiary consumers eat secondary consumers. So a snake eating a mouse. And tertiary consumer is the fourth level. And then the fifth level is quaternary, and these are known as apex predators, the biggest, the baddest, most aggressive animals in the food chain. And nobody really eats the quaternary consumers. They're the apex predators. So the last thing I need to talk about is the rule of 10% and how energy is transferred from one trophic level to the next. So the rule of 10% states only 10% of energy is transferred from one trophic level to the next. Okay, and I'm going to show an image on the next slide that will explain that better. But if you understand that, you might ask right away, why is only 10% passed on to the next trophic level? And the reason is because organisms use their energy. So the energy that you eat, you use it throughout your day because you're living, you're surviving, and you're competing. You're carrying out life, and that takes energy. So one reason why it's lost is because organisms use their energy. And the second reason is because not all parts of an organism are ingested. So bones, bird beaks, fur, hair, all of that stuff is not digested, and there is energy in that material. So this image should help you out to understand the rule of 10%. So with this image, on the bottom, we have the sunlight energy, and all of the sunlight energy is going to the producers. Okay, so in this example, we have 1,000 plants. And if only 10% is going to get transferred on, that means the primary consumers, if we have 1,000 plants, only 10% of 1,000 would be 100. So the primary consumers, there would only be 100 primary consumers. If only 10% of the energy from primary consumers gets passed on, that means we're only going to have 10% of the primary consumers to make the secondary consumers. So 100 crickets, 10% of that is 10 mice. And if only 10% of those 10 mice get passed on, the energy gets passed on to the next trophic level, that means we're only going to have one hawk on top of the food chain. So this explains two things. One, this explains why in the desert there's really not that many organisms that are able to live. Because the size of your ecosystem is going to be based off the size of your primary producers. This also explains why there is not that many apex predators in an ecosystem. If you think of something like a lion in a savanna, it's not like there are hundreds of thousands of lions. Usually there's just, a couple dozen because there's not enough energy in the food chain to support that many apex predators. The final thought here is I just want you to know that in an ecosystem, energy is lost, as I've been saying. So all of the original energy in an ecosystem comes from the sun, and energy is lost at each trophic level. So only 10% goes from the producer to the consumer, the primary consumer, and only 10% of that energy goes to the secondary consumer. The concept of energy being lost is contrast to the idea that in ecology, matter is recycled. So if you don't know what matter is it's nutrients. Nutrients are things like nitrogen, things like carbon, things like phosphorus. These nutrients are needed for all living organisms. So those important nutrients are recycled in an ecosystem. Energy is lost, but matter is recycled. And the reason why matter is able to be recycled is because of the decomposers. So the energy comes from the sun, life carries out, things eat things, consumers eat producers. But then when things go to die, the decomposers break down the dead stuff and turn it back into nutrients for the plants. So that's why we really love the decomposers, is because they recycle nutrients in our ecosystem. This has been a bit of biology with Mr.